Hey guys, keep on rocking 404 here with the Music Breakdown. This time reviewing Lorde's Pure Heroine.
Don't you think that it's boring how people talk?
This is her debut album, and a damn good one at that. So, let's jump right in. So we start off with the best song in the entire album. No, really, it is. The beat is excellent, especially for an opening track. The lyrics deal with her newfound fame that came from her hit single, Royals. That lyrical theme tends to come up a lot in the album, so it's fitting that she'd open the album with it. We also get a good feel for her vocal style, which is just great. The chorus is also great, where the minimalist beat becomes, I don't know, less minimalist. But I know they'll never own me. Baby, be the class clown. I'll be the beauty queen in tears. It's a new art form showing people how little we care. The way the beat builds is definitely a highlight here, and it makes the chorus that much more hard-hitting. It's a superb track. 9 out of 10. The beat's a lot less solid than this track. Same with the lyrics as well, they're just not that great. That's not to say this is a bad track, it's still pretty good and it sounds nice. Of course the vocals are great, but everything else about this track kind of drags them down. Yeah, nice is about the best thing I can say about it. It's a decent track. 6 out of 10.
I've never seen a diamond in the flesh.
Next we have the smash hit Royals. This song really put Lorde on the map, and for good reason. It's no surprise that it became a hit because the chorus is catchy as all hell. On the other hand, however, it's incredibly ironic that this song became a hit. The lyrics are pretty anti-pop, or at least anti-pop lifestyle. That's a pretty cool thing to write a song about, and it doesn't come off as hipster or anything like that. This song's definitely suffered from radio overplay, but I can't really fault the song itself for that. It was one of the best pop hits last year, and certainly a highlight of the album. 8 out of 10. This track is, once again, nice. Unlike 400 Lux, though, it's a lot less forgettable. The vocal delivery is once again great, and the beat's also really good. The lyrics are pretty good too, but it's the way the song builds that's really awesome. The drink you spill all over me, lovers spill left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home, it drives you crazy getting home. The drink you spill all over me, lovers spill left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home, it drives you crazy getting home. It has a much bigger feel than a lot of the songs on this album, and in that sense it stands out. It's a great track, 8 out of 10. This next track has one of the better beats of the album. It has a really fun bass line, and it builds up to a great chorus that has some of the best vocal delivery from Lorde on the entire record. It plays out a lot more simply than a lot of the other tracks on the album, but that's really not a problem. Overall, Buzzcut Season is good. 7 out of 10.
Wait till you're announced. We've not yet lost all our graces.
Here's the other huge hit from the album, and once again, for good reason. I think it's awesome, certainly better than Royals. Especially once the beat kicks in.
Send the call out, 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 send.
The chorus is extremely catchy, even more so than Royals. The kick sounds a little empty though. It's hard to explain, but something feels missing from it. I mean, I don't really take huge issue with it, it's just something interesting to note. I still really like the beat. And overall, Team's an excellent track. 9 out of 10.
There's a humming in the restless summer air, and we're slipping off the course that we prepared.
I'm kind of split in this next track. I absolutely love its chorus, both in its music and in its vocal delivery. On the other hand, however, the rest of this track is incredibly boring and uninteresting, lyrically and sonically. Also, Jesus, listen to the beat on that bridge.
No one around here's good. good at keeping their eyes closed.
That bloop on the snare is really annoying, and it sounds like garbage. However, that chorus is still really fucking good. It's hard to look past. Once it comes in, it becomes a bit easier to forgive the song's flaws. Not easy enough, though. 6 out of 10.
Today is my birthday and I'm riding high.
By this point on the album, the minimalist style and repetitive nature gets really boring. And this track really doesn't attempt to change that or break that up or anything like that, and so yeah, it's really boring. I mean, really, that's about all this song is. Lyrically, musically, even vocally bland. It's not terrible by any means, but there's just nothing to it. So I'd have to call it the worst song in the album. 4 out of 10.
We wouldn't be seen dead here in the day.
Since the style became boring, this next track better really shine through. And it mostly does. The energy is really brought back again. The marching band type snare rolls during the chorus are really cool, and it's very driving. The lyrics are interesting as well, definitely improving over Still Sane. The outro to this song is actually quite beautiful too. It's a good track. I can't call it great, but yeah, it's good. 7 out of 10. Here's the final track, and it definitely serves its purpose. First of all, every time the beat comes in for the chorus, it's fucking great. So yeah, Lorde delivers another great chorus. Also, her vocal delivery is a lot more laid back than most of the other songs on the album, and I think it really works as the closer. I like this one. There's not much to it, but it fits in with a minimalist style. It's a pretty good track, and definitely a decent way to close off the album. 7 out of 10. In the end, I was surprised by this album. It shows a lot of potential for Lorde, and I'd like to see her on the charts again, because this was a really good debut. Sure, it gets boring near the end, and the songs don't really hold a lot of variety, but it's definitely a new sound coming from a pop chart dominated by EDM. It's just a fresh album. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I definitely recommend it to people who aren't big fans of modern pop music, because this shows the potential that it still has. Overall, I give Lorde's Pure Heroine a 7 out of 10.
We live in cities you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how.